friends, this is Madhuri Navle, lecturer in Electrical Engineering Department from KKVAC Polytechnic, Nasik. And here is my today's topic, that is single phase transformer. Before going into deep, I want to tell you that why I have selected this topic and what will be the outcome. As I know, this topic is included in the curriculum of different streams like IT, Computer, E&TC, Mechanical, Chemical Engineering and Electrical Engineering also. So, after completion of this topic, the students will be able to understand what is the transformer, on which principle it works, how to select, connect and operate the transformer for the specific requirement. So, let's begin with what is the transformer. Basically, transformer is an electrical machine which is used to transfer the electrical energy from one AC circuit to another AC circuit, which may increase or decrease the voltage and current level, but the frequency of supply must remain same. Means what? See, suppose I have to decrease the voltage level from 230 volt to 115 volt. For that purpose, I can use the transformer. Here, the voltage level will decrease, but the frequency of input and output is same, that is 50 Hz, and this is the standard frequency in India. Now next is, what is the necessity of transformer? Do you know from where the electricity comes to your home and what is the rating of that supply? There are the three steps of electricity. First, generation, second, transmission and third is distribution. For generation and transmission of electricity, we require the voltage level very high, and for distribution, we require the voltage level very low. For increasing and decreasing this voltage level, we require some machine which is called as transformer. Next is working principle and construction of transformer. See, this is the constructional sketch of transformer. Here we can see the two main parts of transformer. First is the winding of transformer, which is made up of the material copper, and second is the laminated core of the transformer, which is made up of the material iron or silicon steel. There are two windings. First, which will connect to the supply is called as primary winding, and second, which will connect to the load is called as secondary winding. And these two windings are wounded on this laminated core on the separate two limbs. Now, on which principle the transformer works? It works on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction and specifically the mutual induction. See, when we will connect this primary winding to the AC supply, then AC current will start flowing through this winding. After this, the AC flux will get generated here and we will get one EMF is called as self-induced EMF. After that, most of this flux will get linked to the secondary side from primary side, and here we will get the second induced EMF, which is called as mutually induced EMF. So here, this transformer works on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. This is the symbol of transformer. Here is the primary winding, secondary winding, and these two lines represent this laminated core. Now next is the EMF equations. Here we get the two EMF equations, E1 and E2. EMF equation for primary side and secondary side. See, the formula for both is same up to here. That is 4.44, which is the constant value. Phi m means the maximum flux measured in Weber. F means the frequency of supply, which is 50 Hz. For E1, we will take N1, means the number of turns of this primary winding. And for E2, we will take N2 here, means the number of turns of secondary winding. Now next is ratio. There are actually the four types of ratios, and these all are very important for the calculations and design purpose of transformer. First one is voltage ratio. It is nothing but the ratio of V1 by V2. Means what? Primary terminal voltage to the secondary terminal voltage. Second is current ratio, I1 by I2, means primary winding current to the secondary winding current. Third one is turns ratio, N1 by N2, means primary number of turns, primary winding turns to the secondary winding turns. And last, fourth one is K, that is transformation ratio. It is very important ratio. It is given by V2 by V1 or E2 by E1 or N2 by N1, but I1 by I2 for current. Next types of transformer. Actually, there are various types of transformer, but I will discuss only four here, which are very important. First, transformer type is depend on the voltage level. Two types. First is single phase transformer, voltage level is 230 volt, and second is three phase transformer, whose voltage level is 415 volt. Second type of transformer is based on the applications. First one is power transformer, which we can use in the generating station, and second is the distribution transformer, which we can use in the substation. Now third type, which is based on the value of K, that is transformation ratio, which is if the K is greater than 1, then it is called as step up transformer, and if K is less than 1, this is called as step down transformer, and if K is equal to 1, then it is called as isolation transformer or 1-to-1 transformer. Now fourth type is based on the construction of transformer. There are three types of transformer according to the construction. First is core type transformer, second is shell type transformer, and third one is berry type transformer. In our college laboratories, we usually use the shell type transformer, which is having the kV rating of 1 kVA. Now what is the kVA? kVA means kilo volt ampere. You might have heard about that the machine's rating is given in HP, that is horsepower. But for transformer, the rating of power rating of the transformer is always given in kVA, either VA, kVA or MVA. Next one is the losses. Losses means nothing but the wastage of power. As we have seen, there are two main parts of the transformer. First is winding and second is the core. So according to that, there are two types of losses. First is the copper loss, which takes place in the winding, and second is the iron loss, which takes place in this iron core. How to find out this copper loss, which is denoted by the letter PCU? I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. What is the I1 square R1? This is the loss taking place in the primary winding, and I2 square R2 is the loss taking place in the secondary winding. Now second type of loss is iron loss, which takes place in this iron core. This again get divided into two types. First is the hysteresis loss and second is eddy current loss. In hysteresis loss, this loss is directly proportional to the frequency and supply voltage, but the eddy current loss is proportional to the square of frequency and square of thickness of the laminations. This core is not the solidly is not made from the solid iron. The stampings are there and which are stacked together to make this core. This core is laminated always to reduce this eddy current loss. Okay. The next is efficiency. Then how to find out the efficiency? It's very simple, as you find your percentage. Obtained marks divided by total marks into 100. Likewise, we can find out the efficiency of any motor, like output power divided by input power into 100. Here for input power, I must say, or I can say, output power plus losses. Okay, see, this is input power here, this is output power here, and in between losses will take place. So for our input power, I can say it is the output power plus losses. So here I say input power is nothing but output power plus losses, both type of losses, iron loss and copper loss both, and into 100, as we are finding the efficiency in percentage. Next is voltage regulation. What is the voltage regulation? Regulation means change. Okay. Ideally what happens, when we increase the load of transformer, the load current gets increased and the secondary terminal voltage must remain constant. But practically this is not happen. When we increase the load, current gets increased and there is small decrease, small change in the secondary terminal voltage. This is nothing but the voltage regulation, and it is find out as E2 minus V2 divided by E2 into 100. Now next is ideal transformer. What is the ideal transformer, or which transformer we can say this is the ideal transformer? The transformer which is having the 100% efficiency. 100% efficiency means what? The losses, both iron and copper losses in that transformer must be 0%. Then what about the regulation? The voltage regulation must be 0, means the better voltage regulation. Now third point of ideal transformer is the winding resistances, both primary and secondary winding resistances of ideal transformer must be 0. Okay, Then, advantages of transformer. There are various advantages of this transformer. The first one is the construction is very simple. Next one is, as we have discussed, there is no any moving part in transformer, so the friction losses will be completely zero. Then third advantage of this transformer is that both primary and secondary windings are completely isolated, completely separated from each other, so there is no chances of the short circuit. And fourth one is, we can step up or step down the voltage from using this transformer. Now disadvantages. Along with advantages, there are some disadvantages of this transformer. First is, its size is very big. The efficiency is not always 100%. The losses are there. Voltage regulation is poor. Also, we require the two windings. Okay, the copper required is more, and they because of copper, more copper required. The copper losses are always more in this transformer. Now what are the applications where to use this transformer? We can use this transformer in the substation as a distribution transformer. We can use it at the generator station for as power transformer. We can use this transformer in our welding applications also, and many other applications, like we can step up or step down the voltage in our various DC power supplies also. Okay, so from this topic we have learned all these points. From what is transformer to the where to use this transformer. Thank you.